I've heard there's a very famous Dave featuring on tonight's show.
Tonight, on About Tonight, hey, hey, it's Saturdave with David Quirk, Dave Thornton, Dave O'Neill, and Dave Callan with your host, Dave.
3, 4. You're the boys trying to understand it. Make a noise and make it clear. Dave's not gonna sit in silence. Dave's not gonna live in fear. Dave.
Bagpipes.
Yes. A round of applause for the Daves. My Daves. How hot are they? I lent them those t-shirts, so don't get them dirty, guys. Welcome, everyone, to the special Dave edition of Talking About Tonight. That's what it's called. I just flew in from Sydney, and boy, my arm's tired. That's an old joke. Can't take credit for that one. Okay, so we're going to have a good time tonight. We're going to have a good fucking time, aren't we? We've got the camera operators are laughing, so hope you are at home. So I'm single. I don't think it's my fault, though. I don't think it's my fault. I think there's a major flaw in the female anatomy. Fellas know what I'm talking about. The fellas know what I'm talking about. This guy over here, this guy on camera 4 knows what I'm talking about, don't you, mate? He's like, I know what you're talking about. I know what you're fucking talking about. I know what you're talking about. Yeah, major flaw in the female anatomy. Special magic bean, hidden button, a little man in the boat. Yeah, catching on. Everyone knows what I'm talking about. Fellas at home know what I'm talking about. Everyone's looking for it. No one can find it. They should change that thing's name from clitoris to Nemo. You got to get wet if you want to find Nemo, don't you? You got to get wet. You got to go all the way to the Great Barrier Reef. Got to go out on a boat, don't you? Out on a glass bottom boat, probably, if you want to find Nemo, because that's where he is, down there, down in the ocean. Got to go out in a boat. Everyone's looking down, even the little man in the boat. He's looking down. He's got his hood over his head. His hood's the same colour as the boat. He's most fucking fooling him. Jeffrey Rush is flapping around going, mine, 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 mine. As he does, got to call in Ellen DeGeneres, dressed as a fish. She's the only one who knows where to find Nemo, but she keeps fucking forgetting everything. Oh, yeah, that's the joke. That is the end of the joke. But we're going to have a good time tonight. Fuck, I love that movie. It's great. But don't pop it on now. You know, you've got the DVD. You can watch it later. Stay with us. We're going to have a good time. Fucking high fives.
Yes.
Yes. Classic, yes. Dave. Dave's classic Dave. Camera 4. That guy. Camera 3. This guy. What? Camera 6. Camera 11. All right. We're going to... Fuck. I hit my head. I'm going to keep going. We only have one shot of this, right? Fuck. Okay. Everyone's looking for it. Now I can find it. They should change that thing's name from clitoris to Nemo. You gotta get wet if you wanna find Nemo, don't you? You gotta get wet. You gotta go all the way to the Great Barrier Reef. You gotta go out on a boat, don't you? Probably one of those glass bottom boats. Jeffrey Rush is living. Mine, mine. Ellen DeGeneres is a lesbian.
I'm fine. Patch me up. I'm going to continue with the show. So, the doctors have said that I'm not allowed to fall asleep anyway. So, I may as well. You know, I just got to kill the time. So, stay with us. We're going to go to a break now. But after the break, we're coming back with the brilliant Mr. Comedian, Dave Quirk.
Oh, we're halfway there. Whoa.
Thank you, and welcoming it to the set, Mr. David Quirk. Whoa.
Whoa. He's a quirking glass man.
Thanks. Hey, mate.
Good to see you, Dave.
It was good to see you too. I'm good. How are you?
I'm well. Yeah. This is a lovely set you've got.
Thank you. This isn't even real.
Isn't it?
There's no dial tone.
My auntie used to have one.
Your auntie had one?
Yeah, Auntie Margaret, yeah.
Auntie Margaret. She doesn't have it anymore.
I don't know.
No, yeah.
Oh, it's on the wall. It's a different style.
Oh, like this.
They're longer.
They're kind of like really, aren't they? Blast from the past, fucking blast from the past there.
Anyway, yeah.
Anyway.
No, it's good.
So I saw your show.
Did you?
Thrasher!
I didn't
Thrasher.
See you in there.
No,
thank you for coming.
Yes, thanks for having me. It was good. It was all right.
Was it?
Yeah, it was okay.
Yeah what did you make
it? It was better than your show last year.
I would agree. Yeah. Thanks for pointing that out.
Yeah. No, it was all right.
Yeah, it's different, isn't it?
Yeah.
Set in the performed in the in a skateboard shop, isn't it?
Well, I know that, but you didn't
Maybe
know that.
Don't
so
know that.
For the viewers at home, Dave Quirky here, he does a show performed in a skate shop. That's just what you said.
That's just what I said. but that's what I do as well. I've worked in a shop for years and I just thought, oh, let's make a show about my life in a skateboard shop. I have no idea what camera I'm looking at.
And it's the red light. It's that one right now.
Hi.
That one there.
It's the one I haven't looked at all.
Yeah. No, you don't have to look at the cameras though. I mean.
No, it doesn't matter. But yeah, that's so.
Just pretend they're not here. Just pretend they're not there. It's just you and me, mate.
Thank you.
Just fucking shooting the breeze.
Am I your first guest?
You are my first guest, yes.
Yeah, there you go.
I don't know how this works either. I only just worked out that the telephone's not real. I was trying to make fucking calls. The whole first.
Pioneer guest.
Yeah. You're a pioneer, like Christopher Columbus.
Yeah.
Except David.
Yeah, and you're like David Letterman, aren't you?
I am, but Dave.
I'm proud to be a Dave today.
Yeah. Yeah, it's good.
Is that what you got me in here for?
That is the only reason.
Yeah.
I can't stand your comedy, actually, to be honest.
Not a fan? Who do you like?
And as a person, I don't really...
Don't really know me.
I don't know who you fucking are.
So it's not about liking me yet,
no.
Is it?
I don't know, maybe we'll get on really well.
We can work it out.
We could be lovers.
Who do you like, though?
Who do I like?
Who do you sort of... why'd you come to my show if you just heard...
I just heard...
Stuff.
It was like, it's a good gimmick.
Yeah, yeah.
So I can check it out.
Mm-hmm.
And I went, you know, it was a good gimmick.
And I used some, like, a person in there.
Yeah.
This chick.
Some shitty idiot.
Yeah, this bloody idiot.
Bloody idiot.
And,
it's not funny.
She doesn't help the show at all, but...
Oh, I mean, women aren't funny. I don't find them funny.
I got her in the show and it's too late to kick her out. We're at the last week, you know?
Yeah, I know. Yeah, you know, better the devil you know.
That's right.
At this stage.
Yeah.
Even if she's ruining your show. But that's okay. We've all got our cross to bear. We've all got our cross to bear. Don't worry, viewers. It's good to include them. The viewers.
We have to include the viewers. Yeah. I hope they're enjoying it.
Oh, they are too. Does anyone watch this show? I don't know. Not hearing any answers back, so... Who knows what's going on? Anyway, who do I like?
I've heard you're a big Will fan.
Oh, Will love Anson. Will. Love Will. Hilsey. Oh, I like pretty much all of them.
Yeah.
Except your stuff. Look, I'm not going to lie to you.
Bit slow, isn't it?
Just a bit slow.
Yeah,
not enough punchlines.
No. No. Is that what you got me on here for? Thank you.
No, so you're... I'm joking with you, mate.
No, I know.
I'm joking with you, mate.
I
fucking love your shit.
I love it.
It's good. Yeah, I love it. I'm joking. I'm joking, viewers.
It's
I'm
hard
joking.
To tell. It's really hard to tell. No, but Dave, what on God's green earth are we doing?
We're just shooting the shit.
Okay,
just shooting the shit and our buddies at home are watching.
How do you like this sort of thing, this new lifestyle for
it's
you?
It's good. I think I could get used to this.
Yeah.
I like the lighting. I think I'm going to set this up at home.
Just in your bedroom.
Yeah, how do you like? You've done a bit of telly.
Bits and pieces. Yeah, not very good at talk shows, as you can tell.
No, but, you're great. You're going well, mate.
I did a thing in New Zealand, which was borderline horrific, actually.
Did you?
Yeah.
What was it?
I think I said one thing in about 5 hours.
Why were you filming for 5 hours?
That's slow.
Is that how long the show was?
Yeah, they cut it to half an hour. 20 minutes.
That's...
Viewers at home, is that ridiculous to film something for 5 hours and cut it to 20 minutes?
I think that's ridiculous.
Shouldn't they assume that something you'll do is good in half an hour?
Film for half an hour, cut to 20 minutes.
Yeah,
that's what I
can live it. Chuck a few ads in there, cut it to 3 minutes.
We're not going
to
cut this at all.
Really?
Yeah, it's just all gold.
Unedited.
It's just all gold. Everything solid that gold is said in this room is going to be beamed out into the lounge rooms of Australia or Melbourne. Does it go? Who's?
I think it broadcasts just beyond Swanson Street.
Yeah, great. Yeah. It's just Swanson to Elizabeth.
Yeah, yeah, it's just a very CBD base.
Yeah. We can't even pick it up in this building.
No.
No.
We couldn't watch it if we tried.
You can watch it on VHS.
Yeah, we chuck it on a USB.
In the building.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just talking now, aren't we?
Yeah.
Saying letters.
Saying letters, words, A, G. Okay, should I ask you a question? I had some questions here, I haven't asked any of them.
I don't mind.
Okay, here's an important question. I was thinking about this watching your show. Mm. I thought I'd like to know what Quirk has to say about this. Would you rather have a third eye in the middle of your forehead or a tiny hand coming out the centre of your chest?
It's a good question, actually. I would have to say probably third eye.
Third eye?
I was going to say the hand, but then I realised I wear a lot of clothes.
Yeah.
And like a lot of people, I wear clothes, and it'd be sort of like that, wouldn't it? And so I
guess, I mean, you'd have full use of the hand, so you could kind of
wouldn't be like a
flop
dead
it
hand
down like that.
It'd be a full-size hand, would it?
That would maybe make you look a bit gay.
For some reason, I pictured like a baby's hand, just sort of hanging there limp.
Yeah, like a tiny little hand, but you've got full use of it. Like, you can pick things up. So you could, like, write like this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll go with the hand. Yeah,
you're going to go with the hand.
Sounds decent. If it's small and you can conceal it.
I would go with the hand.
Mm.
Just because it would be more useful, I think. The third eye, I've already got two in the same spot.
Would it be good for comedy, probably? You could, like, put the mic back in the stand, just like that.
Yeah, there's a lean on the mic, like this.
Yeah, I think it's a bloody good
gesticulate
idea.
Gesticulate.
I think in the future, all comedians will have them.
I think they should.
Mm.
Like, Stellark. Yeah. He's got that fucking...
I've heard of him.
Yeah, he's got an ear on his arm or something. I think that's for a prop comedy bit. Stellark. Watch out. Watch out, comics. Fucking Stellark's moving in on your territory.
Talking about art now.
Yeah.
Oh, camera,
next thing, bloody Marina Abramovic's going to be showing up at the hi-fi, fucking taking the spots.
You been down to the hi-fi?
Yeah, yeah, I'm there every
been
night.
Been down to the belly of the beast?
Yeah, love it.
Yeah, yeah.
Networking.
Late nights.
Yeah. So you've got a manager, don't you?
Yep.
Yep. Who's that?
They're
it's all right, we're almost done.
They're a
group
group
of people.
There's people in place. They have
one's called
Chris, the other's Michelle.
Yeah. Are they looking for anyone?
Yeah.
Are there any spots?
Do you want me to bring them along to your show or something?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you, Dave Quirk.
Oh, just like that.
No, that's. Do we still? No, we've still got time.
Okay.
We've still got to go. These guys are enjoying it. It's good. Having a good time.
No. Yeah. Do you have a manager?
Do I? No. No.
No, you're just independent.
I know, I seem like I should.
Yeah.
And actually, a lot of my mates have said that to me. Dave, you should...
Get management.
Get a manager. You should have a manager.
Well, that's what everyone does, don't they? Or any good comic.
Yeah, I know. Exactly. That's why they're...
So what's happened to you? You just...
I don't know. I think it's like a bias, because I'm from Sydney.
It might be that. I could think of other reasons.
Yeah. What...
I probably don't do the comedy festival enough. This is your first festival, isn't it?
This is my first festival, yeah. I'm having a fucking
It's probably just you haven't been seen.
I haven't been seen.
Yeah.
So got to get them to actually see the gigs. So I've just been sending emails and...
Saying, put me on.
I need a manager, please manage me.
See me, like, sight unseen, just put me on.
Just put me on.
Yeah.
Look at this face.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm doing this. Anyone?
If you are watching, please sponsor Dave.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. No, I think we are actually, we're pretty much done.
Has this been valuable? Has this been edifying?
I think this has been very valuable for me. So where do you think...
I think in a way this is kind of interesting to watch. Yeah, we've got to wind this up.
We've got to wind up. That's what this means. This means wind it up.
I've done enough TV to know what that means.
The clocks are going quite quickly. Time is... Anyway, yeah, okay, sorry.
Well, Dave, thank you for having me.
Thank you, Dave. Well,
good luck with the rest of your this show.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah. And enjoy the other Dave. They're some of my favourites.
Yeah, it's fucking... It's a Dave fest.
Mm.
It's a Dave cuddle puddle. Thanks, mate.
Ozzy.
Hey, mate.
Thanks for coming.
Cheers, Dave. Good to be here.
You look amazing.
Thanks, Dave. Thanks.
Whoa, he was a quirky classmate.
Welcome back, and next up we've got a real treat for you. Things are going to get pretty wild. We've got one of my favourite all-time Daves, Mr. Dave Thornton.
Because it's a long way to the top if you want to rock and roll.
Hey, mate! Yeah. Yes, it's the
mate.
Thornton!
Oh, what's going on, you boss?
Rosie Queen 2 Thornton!
Oh, here we go.
All right.
Mate, thanks for the band.
Yeah, fucking, aren't they good?
Have a look at you.
Yeah.
You're doing all right.
Yeah, I've grown my neck beard.
Oh, yeah, look at that!
Yeah, it's pretty good. You're looking good too.
How long did this take?
Like 6 or 7 years.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, yeah. I've been working on it for a while, so I'm quite proud of what I've achieved.
Dave, mate, good work. Because, well, I haven't seen you. Remember, we did RSL tours.
Yep, that's right.
When was the last one? I think it was Mount Isa that we did.
Mount Isa, yeah, it was good. Foster Tongue Curry, that was fun.
That was good.
Yep, the carnival there. They've got that carnival on the on the river.
Mate, I've never seen previously like a 5-minute act sell that much merch.
I know. everybody wants my novelty songs. Everyone wants them. Because they're the one you put the, for the viewers, you put your penis through, basically, and it's the trunk of an elephant.
Yeah, it's pretty funny. And then there's that bottle opener at the end of it.
It's really good.
So your mates are just like...
Yeah, and like a lot of people will sell, like, you know, you see that, like, the flamingo or the toucan or the elephant, but none of them have bottle openers, and that's what's different.
You're not hack. That's all I like about you, Dave.
Thank you.
You've got the good gear.
Yes.
Mate, first festival, what's happening? Have you been smashing it or?
I have not, but I think that's more the climate. I think that's the climate. You know, like...
They're not getting your stuff.
They're not getting it, and I think audiences are dumb now.
Yeah, you reckon? Because you are highbrow, I've noticed.
I am quite highbrow. You know, I do a lot of cerebral material.
Yeah.
A lot of, like, you know, like the difference between men and women.
Yeah.
You know?
You still, I love that bit when you you point out with pets, some people that have cats.
Yep.
They've got, like, their own area.
Yep.
I love this. But then there's people with dogs. That's a different area.
Different area.
It's a different area.
They're different people. Cat people, dog people.
Yeah.
So you fucking get it.
Mate, that tore the roof off at the Ari.
Yeah.
That was absolutely,
mate. Remember those chicks? Remember they came up and they were just like, fuck it was like a fucking Dave sandwich.
Mate.
With the Cheryl as the meat.
Mate, it was a Dayful tower.
We were Daved and confused.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Look at this guy. Still got it.
It was a real Dave of reckoning.
Yeah. Daves of thunder. Nah.
Nah.
Nah. Nah. What about the ladies? How they going at the festival?
The ladies.
Are they digging Dave?
They are not. But again, I think that's the climate. I think there's a lot of feminism around, and it is a real boner killer.
Nothing
kills my boner, but you know that, mate. But,
I suppose, yeah.
What about you?
You mean willful ladies, I guess, who have the opportunity to, I guess, you know.
They just don't like me.
Say no or.
They'd say no.
That's probably
a lot.
Not your strong suit, is it?
No, I don't like it.
No, I'm still with my girlfriend, so I'm doing well. You're going well on that front, yeah.
Jeanette?
No, Nicole.
Nicole.
Yeah.
It's got an N in it.
Yeah. Well, not exactly where you put it, but
no. Nicole.
Yeah.
You could.
You've met her probably 30 times or so.
Yeah, I know. But they're all the same to me. They're all the fucking same. All the Nicoles.
Was that a big knock on your head?
It was quite bad, actually.
Yeah, okay, fair enough.
Yeah, I don't know how long we've been filming for, actually, at this point. No. I don't know. But it's good that all my guests are Dave, so I can at least remember that.
Yeah, it just makes life easier. You can look down the name tag and go,
Dave. Dave.
That'll do.
Yeah, Ari, it was good.
Yeah, exactly. you nailed it, mate.
Yeah, mate.
You big packing boss, give it a yeah.
Didn't see why you did that, packing sideways off. I'll do that again.
Look at this guy. Oh, Jesus.
Look at this guy. Look at him.
Look at
the bone structure on that. That's fucking nice.
Well, I believe in the David Palooza, the Big Dave Out.
Yep.
That you also had Dave Quirk on here as well.
He has a very prominent facial bone structure.
Very prominent.
Yep. It's because he's a vegan.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, so he doesn't... he's actually wasting away. That's why he looks like that, because he doesn't eat.
No real nutrients. On the flip side of vegans, Dave, because I notice you don't really eat fruit or vegetables.
They sicken me to my stomach.
Yeah, you're more of just a whole hard flesh.
Just flesh. Flesh. I'll have chips.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
And I will have sauce, which is made of tomatoes. Yeah. Tomato sauce. I will go a tomato sauce.
Would you branch out from that? Barbecue?
I don't mind a barbecue. I don't mind a barbecue sauce, yeah. Aioli, though, fuck off.
Oh, yeah, that foreign stuff.
Yeah, aioli. It's not A-I-O-I.
Oh, you've lost me. Too many vowels.
Too many fucking vowels.
Oh, mate.
Yeah.
Yeah, I noticed you've got a couple of those views. Yeah. You know, we're full, whatnot.
Because we are.
Yeah, Dave, we've talked about this.
Yeah, it's like me after a steak meal, I'm full.
Yeah.
See, that's just joke writing 101. You just get, it's because it means it's the same in two different contexts.
Are you still holding those seminars for TAFE kids on comedy?
Yeah, look, after the lawsuit they did.
You did pull
it
back?
So TAFE has pulled out.
You were joking with me last time, you were fleecing them of their money.
Yes.
That's a direct quote from you.
Yeah. Well, I was fleecing as in I wore a lot of wool.
Yeah.
Yes. So that's what I meant.
But you were saying you put no time or effort into the seminars and you were just taking their money. That was specifically your quote.
I do not remember saying that.
Okay.
But I am still running the seminars just out of my house.
Oh, so people can still drop down if they want to check it out.
Yeah, if you want to check it out, get online. It's Dave's Online Seminars offline.com. Anyway, I can't change the website name now, but...
No, but you're still on MySpace. If you want to get in contact.
Get in contact on MySpace. It's Dave.
Yeah. That's something I look forward to.
Yeah.
That's good, mate.
Yeah.
So, and you got any killer finishes this year with your festival show? Because I know you like to finish strong.
I remember
last set I saw you do, you just necked a pint. That's how you used to finish.
Yeah.
Strong. Mate,
necked a pint.
Destroyed it.
This time it's actually helping me with the merch a lot, actually.
Yeah.
I get my dick out and...
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, and I kind of... it's like a trick. I mean, like, it just pours.
Oh,
it doesn't actually...
Don't ruin it.
I'm not going to give it away. But it does. It's like my dick is necking the pint.
Really?
Yeah, he just like swallows it up.
Oh, so you just, I suppose, you envelop.
Just like
cover
the
it.
Pint glass.
Yeah, right.
Pull it out. I'm a very big urethra.
Yes. I'd heard that.
Yeah, the ladies like it.
A big urethra.
A big urethra.
The
bigger the better. Size matters, ladies. Size matters.
The urethra.
Yeah, you can wear it like a hat.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it is.
Jesus.
Yeah.
What other stuff have you fitted in there?
You've got a pint glass, a lady's head,
a
sandwich, a sub, foot-long sub.
Foot-long.
Yeah, foot-long.
None of this half.
So, I mean sideways though, fucking sideways foot-long.
Save you mongrel.
Yeah.
How do you do it?
With a great degree of patience and concentration, relaxation is important. I do a lot of meditation.
Do you?
Yes.
You have to hit a plane of nirvana to make
to
sure.
To get a foot-long sub inside your foreskin.
Don't give away the seminar. I know a lot of this is in there.
Yeah, and this is why I had to start doing it at my house. Because tape are all to feet. Yeah.
It's red tape, isn't it, mate?
It is.
That's the worst thing about this day and age.
World's gone mad.
Oh, tell me about it.
World's gone mad.
That is not fair.
No.
To stop a man like you flaunting your genius, if I might say so.
Thank you.
Thank you. I don't think the word genius gets used enough.
No.
And it should be used more, especially in relation to me.
Oh, I know, mate, because I was watching on the ABC.
I'd like to say that we are in the presence of another genius also.
But in fairness, I'm like, okay, you can bandy around genius, but I'm a genius with just a normal size urethra.
Yes,
I'm already
of course.
But you know, behind you.
But that's, you know, you've got other things. You've got your fart tricks.
Yeah, guilty.
You've got your fart tricks.
That is true.
And I can't do that.
Yeah.
You know, God made each and every one of us special in our own unique way.
Dave, that is true, and that's how we got on that RSL tour.
I think so. Yes. Yeah, they were like, who is going to spice things up? I know, it's the awesome twosome.
Yeah, that's right.
The gruesome foursome.
Yeah.
Us two.
Yeah, well, that's true, mate. That is true. But no, I was saying, I mean, I love Channel 31, what it's done.
Yep.
But I was watching another channel, ABC.
Yep.
And they had the history of comedy in Australia.
Yes.
I'm up to date with it, and no mention.
No, but that's because they're talking about history. They're talking about your grandpa's comedy.
Oh, yeah, true.
This is right now. Are you mentioned on it?
No.
No, see, that's because we're right now.
Yeah.
See, that haven't made that ring. Made
that actually
ding.
Works.
Yeah, ding, ding.
Mate, that's going to be a manager very soon.
This one, yeah. Hello. Yes, I will. Yes, thank you. Book it.
That's true, isn't it? Yeah. Madison Square Garden.
Yeah.
Take it.
So I thought, you've got a manager, don't you?
Oh, yeah, I do. I do have a manager.
Do you have his email address?
Not near you.
We'll just get that up on the bottom of the screen later. We'll just get that. Yeah, cool.
Yeah.
And the show, Nova?
My show?
Nova?
No, I'm on Fox.
Fox.
Dave. Yeah. Ah. You're not really up in the mornings, are you, Dave?
No.
Just at the hi-fi, aren't you, mate?
I am in the bottom of my shower, just like an inch of water, just soaking my urethra, you know, after a show, especially when I'm gigging.
Whoa. Is there any kind of... Because I would dare say...
In a dead old soak.
Because that's the thing is with beer, you know, it can give you heartburn, I guess.
Yes.
And that's my esophagus, but I mean, for you in the urethra.
It is. It does burn. There is quite a lot of yeast going on.
You thought that may do long-term damage to, say, your reproductive areas?
Yes, I have. I choose to put that out of my mind. Because it's, you know, what is a laugh not worth? Nothing.
Yeah, the future of your children, though.
I guess so. I would make a good dad.
Oh, mate!
Yeah.
You'd make the best dad!
The best dad. Okay, speaking of dad stuff,
yeah.
We're going to play a little game.
Oh, okay.
I thought we could, because this is the special Dave hour.
You're putting time and effort into this, Dave.
I know. I did just before, actually, as you were standing back there, I got these out and I wrote it down. I mixed up the order, so I don't know who's who. There's quite a lot of them in there.
Okay.
We're going to do a guess which Dave. So I will put a Dave on my head and then...
Celebrity Dave.
Celebrity Dave. And right. And you have to tell... You can't say their name, obviously.
Yeah.
But you
yeah.
describe the person. I'll guess who it is.
Okay. Oh, these are like those parlor tricks, like Jimmy Fallon, mate. You really?
Yes, I have done my research. I saw this on Ellen. Except it wasn't with Dapes, so okay. So here we go. I don't know who's first. Can you see that?
Oh, there? Yeah. Okay. I'll just describe it to you.
Yeah.
He's in a band.
Yes.
I believe many times you've said you'd have a beer with this bloke.
Oh. David Attenborough.
No, mate. Band.
Dave Grohl.
Yes, you got it, Dave. Bang.
Yeah. Okay, next Dave.
Nailed it. Oh, okay. Okay. He works on another radio show.
Oh, okay. You can do an impersonation if you want.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus.
Dave. It's Husey. Husey.
Yeah, okay, go on. Yep.
He would not do the show. next Dave.
Okay. I'm assuming... Is this, right, Dave, this guy hides, he's a magician. He would be the kind of guy I believe.
David Blaine.
Yes, you got it.
Yes, I love a bit of magic.
Geez, you know your Daves.
Yeah, mate.
Okay. The guy who went on tour with you on the RSL circuit.
Rodney Rood?
Well, no, Rodney was there. But, no, he, He was the guy, you obviously work your urethra and your talents at pouring beer into it.
Yep.
This guy used his powers of flatulence.
Oh, he's fucking
Thornton.
Yeah,
it's me. That is me.
Oh, all right. I think that's a good point to stop with that one. Who was the next one? Dave Chappelle. Who cares? Fucking English Thornton.
Insignificant, Dave.
Let's mix that up. It came at a very good
distant point. Third, Dave Chappelle. And this kind of...
Dave Chappelle.
Fuck, please. What's he done lately?
Yeah, nothing.
Nothing, mate. He's not tearing the roof off it. Where's your venue at the Comedy Festival?
It's at a little venue called the Laugh Hole.
Yep.
And it is, it's kind of about like 25 minutes out of the city.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, like, I don't even know the name of the suburb. I'm from Sydney. I just go there.
Right.
Yeah.
Maybe we just hand out your address too while you're at it, just for the ladies out there.
We'll do. We'll just get that up on the bottom of the screen.
Yeah.
All right.
Put that up there for later.
Put that up there. Okay, they're doing this again.
Oh, they're doing
so
those
we got
ones.
A bloody yeah. Okay.
Good job, you
thanks,
big
mate.
Boss.
You, oh, oh yes,
mate.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
Oh, we got it.
It. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Oh, my mic's gone as well.
Oh, good one. That was good.
Yeah.
It was a long way to the shop, but he got his sausage roll.
$1.50.
Yum. And welcome back. We are live from New York. It's today tonight, about tonight, today's tonight, back in, yes. So thanks for not turning the show off. I really appreciate it. It really means a lot to me. So our next guest, when I first saw this guy performing at the Laugh Hole, I went home that night and I said to my housemate, Mum, I think that I have just seen Generation Y's answer to Kevin Bloody Wilson. And he certainly is. He's probably my personal favourite, Dave. Dave O'Neill!
Well, there's a little Dave waiting at the counter of the corner shop.
Hey! I'm a fan!
Yes!
Good to see you, Dave. I'm Generation X, so I'm not a Y. I'm Gen X.
I know.
Just to clear that up.
I was just, you know, I was flattery. You know, I like to...
Oh, that's good. Yeah. I've been called a baby boomer too, which is really insulting.
A baby boomer?
I'm not a baby boomer. I'm a Gen X person.
You heard it here first. Not a fucking baby boomer.
Nah, stuff that. They ruined the world.
Yeah, and now they own it.
Yeah, we just, like Nirvana, whatever.
Yeah,
anyway.
So you're Gen X.
Gen X, man. A lot of Gen X Daves. There's a lot of us out there.
Yeah, I guess it was a popular
big name in my high school. There would have been at least 8 Daves in Form 1, Year 7 at least.
Did they all become stand-up comedians?
A lot of them left become tradies.
Tradies.
Or real estate agents.
Yep.
When I started comedy 25 years ago, how many Daves were there? Me. Just me.
Just you. The original Dave.
The original Dave. And then Dave Grant started. Oh, no, there was Dave Brown. He was around.
Yep.
And then Dave Hughes started. Then it just went all out the window. It was like...
After Hughesy.
Yeah, it was like, you know, when Woolworths started selling sushi. That was like when Dave Hughes started.
Yeah, it's like, oh, fucking run of the mill. Oh, another Dave.
Mainstream. It's just everyone.
Fight at a 7-Eleven.
It's like, I used to be quite unique. And now you're here.
Yeah.
There's a show about Dave's. It's very impressed.
We've reached critical mass.
Critical mass of Dave's, but there's not many Dave's. Because I've got kids, I know there's not many Dave's out there now.
No.
We're going to be like the Trevors of... Or the Gordons or the Stans.
Yeah, or the Pearls.
Pearl's
coming back,
Pearls,
I think.
Hazel's coming back, Pearl's coming back. Yep. But you know what? Raylene will never come back.
No, I've got a cousin called Raylene.
Yeah, Raylene.
Raylene and Kareen.
Kareen
and Raylene.
Cheryl? Not coming back.
Not Cheryl.
But Dave, David.
David could come back. I went to school with a kid who was a few years younger than me. He was a David, but I think he was the only one at the school.
Yeah. I was a David. The only people that called me David was my mum.
The other one.
My mother-in-law. Yeah, David. Yeah, but I'm Dave to most people.
Yeah. Good.
That's why I'm on this.
Good. Does your mum call you David when she gets
angry.
Mad?
Yeah, yes. Or David Jeffrey when she does the two names.
David Jeffrey. So that'll make you Dave Jeff.
Yeah, Dave Jeff. Dave Jeff.
You should do that. Hyphenate it. Fucking...
Well, there's always this big thing about... I remember Hughesy tried to be David for a while.
Oh, did he? David Hughes.
Point of difference.
Well, you know, Quirk goes by David.
David Quirk. Yes, David he does Quirk. That, but he suits it.
He sort
it's,
of.
It's to do with it's the last name, the Quirk, David Quirk. He's better as David.
Yeah, but everyone still calls him fucking Dave because it's like you want to take him down a notch. It's like, what do you think about the fucking
Queen?
It's
probably not even his real name. He's probably Malcolm or something. No, Malcolm. He's probably like Hamish or Josh.
Hamish or like Oliver.
Or Brandon or Oliver.
Tristan.
Yeah, Tristan. Probably. That's a classic Gen Y name.
Tristan Quirk.
Yeah. Tristan Quirk, we know your secret, Dave.
Yeah, you fucking liar.
Lying bastard.
Yeah. Are you Jewish? You're not Jewish.
I'm not Jewish.
All these bloody Davids, none of us are Jewish.
What? Who's Jewish?
Well, David is a classic Jewish name.
Yeah, it's a biblical name.
And Goliath.
Yeah, it's a biblical name. Isn't it? Yeah. Yeah, no, I'm not Jewish. No. Wish I was. Yeah. But I'm not.
No, neither.
I did a gig for the Jewish Football Club. And obviously they're all Jewish.
And they booked you because they were like, David, he's obviously going to be classic, nebbish humour.
They were all the dads, and I said to this guy, what do you do for a job? And he goes, I work in mining. I go, oh, you work in a mine? He goes, no, I own a mine. He owned a mine. They were all it's like a stereotype, but I said, am I the poorest guy in the room here? They all went, yeah.
Well, you're a comedian. You're always the poorest guy in the room.
But I wish I had born Jewish. Would be good.
Yeah. Well,
a lot of comedians are Jewish.
A lot of comedians. Yeah. Not so many in Australia. Not as many in Australia. No. It's more of a...
More American. English. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah. Because we've got taken up all the Dave space. With Gentiles. With fucking Gentiles.
Well, you're right. They're pretty Anglo-Saxon Daves.
Yeah.
You don't have any Greek Daves or Italian Daves. They're all like...
David. What about... Well,
oh, yeah, David.
Yeah. No. I don't know, I just said David with an accent. That's what...
Dave Callan, who's Irish, but again, that's...
That's Irish.
That's Irish.
Isn't it?
Not, you know...
It's not Jewish.
Not ethnic.
Or... No.
It's a very Anglo-Saxon name.
Yeah.
It's very Australian.
Very fucking Australian.
Fuck yeah.
Dave.
Can we swear on this program?
We can. Fuck.
Awesome.
Yeah. They told me I'm allowed to have maybe two cunts. That's one.
Don't blow your load too early.
No, I know.
Yeah, well, you know, often that's... I'm amazed people use that word in stand-up. When I started, you couldn't really say that word in stand-up.
No.
If you said that word, people would boo and stuff, and now it's, these youngsters, every second word's...
Yeah.
Dropping the C-bomb.
Yeah, well, we can't say it again. Shouldn't.
Don't.
Not too close.
No, we'll keep it.
We'll keep it.
Keep it clean.
So, you were doing a show at the Comedy Festival. Yeah. I don't want to talk about it.
Nah, fuck it.
I don't want to talk about mine. I had to fucking cancel it.
What's your show called?
Dave.
Just Dave?
Just Dave.
And do you get people turning up thinking they're seeing the wrong Dave?
Yeah, everyone...
Because that's the problem about being a Dave is that I do get mistaken for Dave Hughes occasionally.
Yeah, and people show up and then they're like, you're the wrong fucking Dave.
The fuck?
Boo!
Who is this? You put on weight. Who are you?
Who are you? Do your voice.
Then I have to go, what's going on? How are you? Yeah, I don't know. What is he doing? I'm from Warrnambool or Portland. No, Thornton. That's all right. I do get my second for a day. My show's going all right. It's called Not Cool. So, I'm at Trades Hall.
And it's about
being cool.
These people. It's not going to be advertising because the fucking festival will be over.
Well,
by the
I'm
time
probably
we
never going to do it again.
Good.
But you know, I'm around. I'm doing stuff.
Yeah.
I'll do another show.
Good.
So your show was cancelled.
My show. I got a half a star review from Bella Razor. Really mean tweets. Really mean tweets.
Yeah, there was a Facebook campaign against you.
I know.
Well, you should stop doing those rape jokes at the start of your show. That's not great.
They are classic. They're classic.
Yeah, they're
good.
But they've got to be very funny to get away with it.
No, I just think they've just got to be there. Look, I've only got that material. That's the thing.
Yeah, but I know you. You're more like a triad around the circuit. I don't want to insult you, but you're more a bit. You don't have a whole hour. You've probably got a good 5 to 10. Yeah.
Yeah, I know, but that's why I'm trying to do the thing, stretching it out. So it is hard to stretch 5 to 10 minutes to an hour.
Very hard.
Yeah, I've got a tight 5 and a loose 60.
I find it hard. I've been going for 25 years.
All right. Well, that's actually all we've got time for, mate. That's our time.
When are we working again? Are we doing the laugh hole or what are we doing?
Yeah, laugh hole.
Chuckles. We're doing chuckles.
Chuckles
in Brisbane.
Hole. Yeah.
Yeah, it's gonna be a good one.
Gonna be a good one. All right, and that's Dave. Dave O'Neill!
Dave's rule!
Yeah! Good one.
What about Dave? It isn't fair. Dave's had enough, now it won't.
welcome back. Hi. Hello. Now, our next guest is a personal favourite of mine. He won the 2013 hashtag LOLOL Twitter competition of best joke in March. And I don't know if you remember 2013 in March, but it was a pretty good month for tweets. So that is a high accolade. He won it with his famous joke, now famous, after the competition. I like my women like I like my coffee, too hot to put my dick in. And welcome to the stage, or the set, welcome to the fucking set, my favourite Dave Callan.
Dave.
Welcome.
Hello.
Hi.
I don't remember any of that.
Any of that, the Twitter stuff. Well, you were doing a lot of drugs at the time, weren't you?
Yes.
Yep. This guy, you were on some of that pretty rough MDMA that Denise Scott was giving everyone at the time.
Yeah, I was on marijuana and amphetamines.
Yes. Yep. And they slow you down and speed you up at the same time, don't they?
Yes.
Yeah, it's like a whole...
It speeds up one half of your body and the other half it slows down.
Yeah, so
if you... Yeah. Totally like that. It's, and like, if you go for a morning run, you just go around in circles.
Yeah, that's tough. I remember you doing that, actually, and then you got really kind of, like, built on one side, like a very big right thigh. Yeah. Was it the right?
It was definitely the right.
Yeah, the right thigh just got, like, huge.
Yeah, because you're always noticing my thighs.
I love your thighs.
Yeah.
They are probably, I would have to say, my favourite thighs in the Melbourne comedy scene.
Really? Yes. Can you please tweet that?
I will. Cool. I've got like about 64 followers now, so
yeah. Okay.
They're going to be into it.
I'll make it 65.
Yeah.
And my mum will be 66.
Thank
Would my
you.
Mum like what you tweet?
She will when I start tweeting about your thighs. Because she made them, didn't she?
She made my thighs.
Yeah.
What they are today.
Well, not you've done a lot of work. There was that working out that you did. And then there was you had to kind of... spend that rehabilitation time actually running the other way, didn't you?
I did. Yeah, I had to take the opposite but complementary form of the marijuana amphetamines to make me go the other way
as
well.
The other one. You get the hydro and then you have to get the natural ones. Or
you know all about this.
Oh, I was on them for years, mate. I was on them for years. I was like Bell's palsy of the body. This side just didn't move at all. And I was just like,
I know you're interviewing me, but what suburb are you from? What suburb do you live in?
I am from Blacktown in Sydney.
New South Wales Blacktown?
Yes, Blacktown, Blackers.
That explains why you know all about hydro and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, Blacktown, if you're watching.
Well, I did actually grow up on the north coast of New South Wales.
Yep.
I live in Blacktown now, but I grew up in a little place called Grafton.
Yes.
And it is...
Did you go to Grafton Primary, my favourite band?
Well, you know, the thing about this is Grafton Primary does not actually exist as a school. It's actually, technically, it's called Grafton Public, but yes, I did go there.
Wouldn't that be a good name for a band, Grafton Public?
Yeah, it was so much better than bloody Grafton Primary. Boys, if you're watching...
Yeah. Come on.
Come on.
You know, get it right.
Yeah, get it bloody right.
Before you print it on the records.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. Now, I would just like to point out... At this point, we have had to film over a couple of days, so I just want to acknowledge that, yes, there are some continuity issues. Sorry about that. Sorry about any continuity errors. I would just like to point out, I'd like to acknowledge, we have had to shoot over a couple of days, so there will be some continuity issues. I just want to apologise for any continuity errors. All right, yeah, anyway, so now that we've acknowledged that, got that out of the way, and thanks to the band who are definitely live in the studio. I grew up there. There's actually quite a lot of pot going on North Coast.
Did you buy this phone in Blacktown?
Yes.
Does it have any sweet apps?
It has Angry Birds.
Oh, yeah.
See that, like, it's like the original version of Angry Birds where you just fucking chuck it at birds.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
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 Get them.
Flipping Angry Birds.
Yeah, I hate them. I hate them. Why are they so angry?
I reckon because they have a chip on their shoulder. Did you see what I did there?
Oh, because
birds eat chips sometimes.
And because birds don't really have shoulders, if you think about it, do they?
They don't have any.
No, because they've got kind of the wings, they sort of come out from...
Yeah, that's true. I've noticed this as one of the world's most foremost Latino comedians.
Yeah, I love your Latino comedy. It's good. But talking about where you grew up, so were you doing... Did you start doing comedy back in Scotland?
What? I'm an Irish person.
What? No.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
I'm fully Irish as.
Are you sure you are?
I was born in the country of Ireland. That's what made me an Irish person.
But the accent is Scottish.
Well, it's Irish.
That's... Are you sure? Because I've... Yes. For years, people have been like, Scottish comedian Dave Callan.
Oh, there might have been... There's a running joke where people call me Scottish as deliberately, because I think it's... Some people do think I'm Scottish, though. I think it's because I'm so hairy.
Yeah,
like, hairy is a Scottish thing.
You look like an extra from Braveheart.
I do.
Yeah.
Yeah. One of the Scottish ones.
Yeah, okay. So you would... But there were some that one Irish guy in... And then all his mates came.
Yeah, all the Irish mates came. But I didn't look like them. I looked like the Scottish ones.
Yeah, you did.
I do look like Groundskeeper Willie. That's the main thing I think people think.
But he's a redhead, isn't he?
Yeah, he is.
Yeah.
But I have abs like him. I don't really.
Yeah, I do. I do, but only on one side. I'm still trying to work it out.
Yeah, but you draw them on.
I do draw them on. That's why I got my texture here. I like to just freshen up, never without my Sharpie.
Yeah.
You never know when you're going to go home with a lady.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You never do know. Make sure you have your affairs in order and your apartment spick and span.
Exactly. It's you heard it here first, folks.
Yes.
Some lady advice from... Are you sure Irishman?
I am an Irish person. Whenever I go home, I go to the country Ireland. That's how I know.
Whereabouts in Ireland are you from?
It's called Dundalk.
Dundalk. Dundalk.
I feel like I'm back in high school. This is exactly what I got in year 11 and 12. Dundalk.
Dundalk, you fucking Dundalk. Oh, that is unfortunate.
I'm getting flashbacks.
Dundalk. Yeah. So you didn't do year 11 and 12 in Dundalk. You went to like Big Dick or something.
I definitely did.
Yeah.
I went here in year 10. I went to...
Oh, shit.
Australia.
Oh, and they were like...
I did never go to Scotland.
Yeah, and they were like, ah, you Scotsman, saw you in Macbeth. Look at you, buddy.
Were you back there in high school? Because I'm getting serious flashbacks to being bullied.
By
a dude called Dave.
Yeah, that was me.
And I was like, oh, bloody Dave.
It's good to see you again, man.
Have you got a time machine?
Yeah.
That's what this thing
That's
is from,
That's what this
isn't
is.
It?
Chuck it at birds, travel through time, bully Dave Callan.
Oh, yeah. Triple functions.
Yeah.
They're the best apps ever.
Yeah, you could... Yeah. Good sport, though. You're quite good to bully.
Thank you. I feel like I'm quite easy to bully. There's lots to pick on.
Yeah. Like, oh, look at your leather jacket.
Yeah, that's a good one.
What are you... A terrible vegan or something.
Yes, I am a terrible vegan.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm going to have a go at bullying you now.
Okay.
Hey, who made your background? The flippin' Wombles or someone?
Yes.
Yeah.
They didn't.
They're the shittest buildings ever. What is that a representation of, like, Perth? Oh, no, wait, I'm from Perth. I'm bullying myself.
Live from Perth, it's the Dave Callan bullying show.
That backfired on me.
You're terrible at this.
Yeah.
Like, what about, I mean, I could bully myself. Oh, look at you silly girly face neck beard.
Oh, neck beard, that's a bad one, isn't
it? Yeah. Yeah, your beard's lovely. It's all up on your face.
Yeah. I shave the neck part and then I just let the face part grow. You should give that a shot.
I've been shaving like just here.
Oh,
I just shave here and I let this grow.
Hey, Dave, who do you think you are? Abe Lincoln? Yeah, that was a good bully. That was a good one.
Yes, Abe Lincoln. A Blinken. Someone who blinks.
A Bully Killen.
A Bully Killen from Dundalk.
Hey.
You Dundalk.
Oh, you're getting me again. Why did I come here?
I don't know. So how's your show going? You doing a comedy festival show?
I'm doing the festival with the comedy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What venue are you in?
I am in the Trades Hall.
Ah, Trades Hall. Just had Dave O'Neill in here. He's in Trades Hall too.
Yeah, he is. Yeah, we're the two Daves in there.
Yeah, good.
And you should join us. There'd be three.
I should. I couldn't get an FMV though. They told me to fuck off.
Oh, you could. We could end up calling it the Dave's Hall if enough of us go there. You'd like that.
Yeah,
wouldn't you?
Dave. Yes. Mm. Yeah, but at the moment it's just two Daves. It's not enough Daves, really.
Nah, it's the Daves and heaps of other people Hall.
Yeah. Yeah. How are your numbers?
Well, they've been healthy enough. Midweek it gets a bit kind of half full, you know how it is.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
People are like, oh.
I had to cancel all mine. No one came.
Did
no
you?
One came.
Oh, what?
But yeah, you know, do you have a manager?
No.
Oh, you don't? Because I'm looking for one.
Do you want to? Maybe I could.
You want to manage me?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. Because you'd have all those connections, those dumb dog connections.
Yeah, and I know heaps of people who want guys called Dave.
Yeah.
But the problem is, like, if someone rings me up and goes, I'd like to book Dave, I'll be like...
Which one?
Yeah.
Well, in the case of this show, all of them. We're going to have to go to a commercial break now. I don't know which camera is happening, but I'll just look at them all, one at a time. We're going to commercial break, and we are... I can see you pointing at that one. So, and don't go away, because we're going to come back with my my little bullying friend here. Dave Callan.
All the single Davies, all the single Davies, all the single Davies, all the single Davies, all the single Davies. Now put your hands up.
Party girls, don't get hurt, can't feel anything. When will I learn? I push it down, push it down. I'm the one for a good time call, phone's blowing up, ring on my doorbell, I feel the love, feel the love. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, drink. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, drink. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, drink. Turn back till I know.
Just holding on for tonight. No one just. just holding on for tonight, on for tonight, on for tonight.
Anyway, that's all that we've got time for this evening. So thanks for tuning in. This has been About Tonight with Dave, and the Daves as well. So thanks so much. You guys are legends.